Hi everyone, it's John
and Ben,
and it's time for Dinosaur Dracula Fun Pack August edition.
Yeah.
And it looks a little flatter than usual this month.
Yeah, we got another envelope this time.
So should we just go ahead and see what's in it?
Where's the bin squad?
I almost forgot about that. Leave a comment down below letting us know you're here, and let us know if you're excited for Halloween, because I'm going to guess this is going to be the official kickoff of the Halloween season.
Oh yeah, it is.
You and Matt have that in common. You both start celebrating Halloween way too early.
It's not too early. Oh, let's see what's in here. Ooh.
Hang on, there's more in here. Okay, that's everything. But the first thing we see on the top is this one of those sticker albums?
Yep. Yeah.
This is one of the Panini sticker albums.
Of the Tick. I don't know if any of you remember the Tick.
Well, I think he's coming back. I think
is he?
Amazon or something.
Oh.
What year is this from? So this is from 1995. I don't see any stickers in here, but maybe there are some Tick stickers.
Maybe.
In the plastic sleeve.
Maybe. All right. We have the horror sticker on the envelope.
The video store sticker?
Yes. Okay, let's just take this out real quick. All right. Let's see what we have. First up, we have the Snoopy and Friends. We have Charlie Brown, the Great Pumpkin stickers.
8 sheets of stickers. That's a lot of stickers in there.
He's coming. The Great Pumpkin is coming. Oh, we need to watch The Great Pumpkin. I think we should...
When we get closer to Halloween, we'll watch The Great Pumpkin.
No, I think we should watch The Great Pumpkin. Yeah.
Here are the Tick stickers right here. We have one pack.
Okay,
so
let's do it.
We're going to have to do this up right now.
Let's do it.
Okay, first up, I have sticker number 24. This looks a lot like the Street Sharks one.
Oh.
I think it's like recreating the first episode.
Oh, neat.
Okay, there we go.
Okay.
Next up, I have sticker 129. 129.
The Tick broke free from the wreckage, rising out of it with Charles safely under one arm, Amelia under the other. Arthur climbed up from the debris. Breathing is good, he gasped. I was just reading
So next up is sticker 65.
Do you like my dramatic reading? I could be a dramatic reader. That's what I should.
Of course, it's not going to make sense reading it all out of order.
No.
So, that was 65.
Yes.
So this one goes here. And the Tick is saying, must save city. And next up we have 47. And the word balloon says, no prison can hold Chairface Chippendale. 47, so this one goes right here. Okay, I got two more. I got sticker 95. And a police officer or security guard is saying, ow, watch out, big dog.
Security guards are powerless against the metal monster. It knocks them aside, flies over them, or just downright scares the pants off of them. It's relentless pursuit of the device.
And
I don't know what the device is.
Last sticker of this Panini pack is number 19.
Okay, you have no reaction to my awesome dramatic reading. I think I should be hired for audiobooks. Okay.
19.
Right there. Very nice.
And what's his little word bubble saying?
So, you guys got any super action going on here? That's what it says.
So we're a few stickers short, but that's a good start.
I think we're about 150 short, but hey, you know, you gotta start somewhere.
We're accumulating a pretty good collection of
Panini sticker
books. Yeah, I know we have Beetlejuice and Slimer and Gremlins and
the shark,
Street Sharks.
Street Sharks.
So what else? Oh, we have two,
not one,
but we have two Dino Drag stickers.
Well, it's because we didn't have the box for one of them to be attached to.
We have the poster. It looks like the toy version of Dino Drag and a few creepy action figures.
I like it. Goosebumps!
Oh, we got two. Was this a mistake? He threw in two posters. We have some Goosebumps color clings. These are static cling window decorations.
Ooh.
We have the hamster, the cuckoo clock of doom. It looks like we got a mummy. And the mummy's hand down here, the Goosebumps logo.
I wonder if they still cling.
I'm sure they do. These are only from 1996. I bet they still cling.
They probably still cling.
They look like in perfect condition.
They do. Nightmare Before Christmas!
We have the Nightmare Before Christmas poster book featuring scenes from the hit movie.
Oh!
These are actual pull-out posters featured inside.
Oh my goodness!
This is from 1993, so this is like vintage when the movie originally came out. You get a who's who of the characters.
Oh my gosh!
So here's one poster. Here's Jack in Christmas Town.
I love this.
A little bio of Tim Burton. Are we some poster short?
Well, this one, I think, this counts as a poster here. This is a poster. Then we have this poster.
The big poster in the middle, and then this one's a poster. Okay, I get it. Yeah. And then there's a little behind the scenes stuff.
Yeah.
I thought there were going to be more posters, but that's pretty cool.
That is pretty neat. Oh, and we have a poster.
This looks like vintage Halloween-related newspaper advertisements.
Oh my gosh.
A little montage.
I remember these Halloween buckets from Happy Meals. I used to get those all the time. I actually lost one in the lake once. Yeah. Lost one in the lake once.
And remember the costumes where it was just a plastic mask and like a plastic smock you wore it once and then it would like rip apart. Well, there's the Great Pumpkin on VHS.
Domino's Witch.
Trick or treat at Domino's Pizza. Get a free Domino's Pizza and a cup of Coke.
That's a good deal. They should do that again.
And Ghoulies playing at the theater down here.
Oh. So what's that?
We have a specimen in the bubble wrap.
Okay.
It's not often that the cards come last. I think we went through this in reverse.
We opened it upside down, yeah.
So, this is a film cell from Beetlejuice.
Oh, neat.
This is specimen number 37, included one film cell. Oh, and we actually have a film cell of the man himself. Don't say his name three times, but...
Let's see if I can get it on camera.
They actually may have already said the name three times in this video.
Well, yeah, but they weren't, like, you know, close together or anything. Whoops. There he is. Oh, that looks really good, actually.
You get a good shot? I can't see.
Look at that. I'm just kidding.
Okay, Matt has some pointers here on how to have a spooky September. Five ghoulish tips by Matt from DinoDrac.
Number one, decorate for Halloween.
Never waste September. Okay, ready? I'm just gonna go through the bullet points, guys. Okay. I'm not gonna read the whole thing.
Okay.
Number one, vow to watch an entire horror franchise, one with a lot of movies. Number two, visit someplace haunted. Number three, search eBay and buy back a piece of your Halloween history. Number four, make plans for a big trip during October. And number five, get spooky when you fall down those internet rabbit holes. Like, I suppose when you, like, look for, like, old creepy commercials or trailers or something. So, those are some things, you know, to warm up for the big month.
Well, I think we should go on another, like, ghostly encounter video for our vlog like we did last year. I think we should do that.
So here's the newsletter, but we can't get to the art challenge yet because we still have some trading cards. I don't even know what these are yet.
No, okay.
Okay.
Ready?
First reveal, go Ben.
Space Shots.
Okay, I was expecting something a little more Halloween-y, but...
These are from 1991. Blast off with the first series of Space Shots and then begin the countdown for Series 2. Scheduled soon. That's what it says on the back. Okay. Oh, these are neat. They're not glossy like I was expecting, but there's Mars. This actually goes well with the eclipse that we just had, space related. There's San Francisco. I'm sure it looks a lot different now than from 1991. Oh, wouldn't that be cool? Like floating out in space. The moon. We have Walter Cunningham, an astronaut, of course. Of the Gemini 7, Skylab, here's a picture of the moon rise, and here's a shuttle taking off, inside Gemini 4, Gemini 3, this is all Gemini related, and another person sitting out on the, out in space, and here's New York from space. I bet that's changed a lot too.
Okay, let's see if we get something a little spookier.
Okay.
Baywatch! Coming at the tail end of summer.
Well, I guess it depends on what your version of spooky is.
9 gold foil stamped cards.
Oh.
Whoa, and these are from 1995, so this must be peak Hasselhoff.
Yeah,
it is. Baywatch.
The Hoff. I used to watch Baywatch. Did you used to watch Baywatch?
I think everybody. Yeah. At least an episode or two. It was one of those things that was always like on.
It was always
like,
on. Always.
So, Baywatch episodes. And they're the glossy ones, so they're kind of stuck together. Bear with me. So, how many Hoff cards do we have? There's one. The Hoffometer. Hang on, you got another one here.
Two.
Here's another one. Three. So we're 3 for 3.
Three Hoffs.
Oh, here is a non-Hasselhoff card.
Okay. They're kind of hard to see because where they're glossy, they like take off part of the other image.
This is Baywatch Confidential.
Oh. Ooh.
I don't know why there's like puzzle pieces for a background.
Oh, that's weird.
There's this one. Baja Run. This is episode 5004.
5004?
Maybe it's season 5, episode 4.
Okay.
Baywatch bios. Behind the scenes. Oh, here's another confidential one. I guess the confidential ones have the puzzle pieces in the background. Here is a little insert where you can sign up for... let's see. Yes, I want to be on Sport Time starting lineup. I'll receive all my team discounts all year round. Membership includes blah, 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 blah. Only $30.
No. Oh. So there are only 3 Hoffs. Hasselhoffs in that deck.
So yeah, I guess only 3 out of the 9 were Hasselhoffs.
Mm-hmm.
And last but not least, we have William Shatner's Tech World. Randomly packed tech chrome and autographed cards. These are from... 1993, so I guess even William Shatner just got into the trading card market.
Interesting. Do you think any of them will be autographed?
Oh, how amazing would that be?
That'd be pretty cool.
I have never heard of Tech World. I don't know if maybe it's a comic book, or was it... I don't know. Let's find out. These are glossy, too, so they look like comic panels.
Oh, they do.
I'm going to hand them to you. You look for William Shatner's autograph.
Okay, I would imagine that you would be able to see it.
Okay, here's another one. I have no idea what's going on here. But it definitely looks like a comic book.
Mm-hmm.
Looking unlikely that we're getting an autograph card. Or even a randomly packed tech chrome card. Nope.
Wah, wah, wah.
Well, if you remember William Shatner's Tech World...
Let us know.
Maybe we'll have to Google that and fall down that internet search rabbit hole.
Okay.
You ready for the big moment?
Ready.
The art challenge this month. On the back of the sheet of paper, draw and color a monster on its first day of school. Maybe a little boy Dracula went to class carrying a Trapper Keeper and wearing a Ninja Turtle shirt. Your call.
All right.
Thank you. And we have finished. We have a mummy.
We have the mummy roaming through the hallways. And he has some awesome high top sneakers with a very rad backpack. He's heading to his locker over here. Getting ready to go back to school. This was perfect to get me into the Halloween spirit.
Just a little taste in August, as August comes to an end.
A little taste.
What was your favorite thing? Was it the Nightmare Before Christmas book, the Snoopy stickers, the Beetlejuice film reel?
I really like our shot of Beetlejuice, for sure, but it's definitely the Nightmare Before Christmas poster book. I love that. That is so cool.
I really love this montage poster of old newspaper clippings.
That brings back the memories.
I have to go with the vintage Nightmare Before Christmas book as well, just because it came out when the movie came out.
I feel like I need to get a frame and, like, full, you know, where the half pages with the full, like,
of this one?
Yeah, that one. I think I need, like, a frame for that. You know, keep the whole book intact, of course, but just put it in the frame. That would be awesome.
Let us know what your favorite was down in the comments. Let us know if you're getting more and more in the Halloween spirit every day.
Like I am.
If you want to see what Ben and I are up to when we're not reviewing toys, go check out our daily vlogs.
And you can check out some of our other toy reviews.
We'll see you next time, everybody.
Bye.